went, but you know, I would like to see Camboso's one, you know, pull it off, because he was the underdog. He was the fighter nobody even talked about before he beat Teofimo. Nobody knew who he was. I was one of them. I never heard of him before. I had never seen him fight. And he, you know, we were watching it with my dad and my sister and my sister Jackie, and you know, we were actually in Tahoe when we were watching that fight, and we were so happy for Cambosos. You know, at the same time, I'm happy for Lou de Bella because he's my friend. Peter Kahn, you know, another one, and I like the trainer, you know, Centeno. I really like that man, and he's done a great job. But you know, it was one of those opportunities that he got, and one of those very few times where the underdog wins.
Now,
and he beat the superstar. And so now I would love to see him win, but I think Haney wins.
Well, they have like a weird deal here where they have one fight. If Camboses loses, there's a rematch. If Camboses doesn't lose, no rematch, I guess. And then yes. If Haney beats Camboses twice, then he fights Loma.
Yes, we'll see. Those are the deals that's the deal that Canelo does also with Matchroom, and he also did that one fight deal with PPC. So you know, I think Tank is in the position to do something like that too. He could come and do something with Top Rank for three fights, and only three fights, none of that extensions or anything like that. And if he's able to do that, he could fight, you know, that you know, the Lomas, you know, Haney's stuff, you know, even at 140 he could still fight. There's a lot of 140 pounders that Top Rank has that he could fight, and that are fights that are worth a lot of money.
Yeah. Why did you think initially? I just asked you, who do you think wins? You said Haney. What is it? Do you think it's the experience?
No, not experience, because Haney doesn't have that many fights either. But I think it's just the skills. He's a better boxer. I think he's gonna fight on the outside. I think he's gonna win a decision. I think he's gonna win by points.
It's possible, but I know one thing is for sure, Robert. That fight does not end in a knockout.
Well, exactly. So if it's if it's a decision, you're fighting in Australia. So that's gonna be a big question. You look at what happened to Pacquiao when he fought that guy from Australia.
Hey, listen. So, you know what's funny? We all know Manny got robbed. I don't care. You could be Stevie Wonder.
Exactly. Freddie. Everybody knows.
Wait, Freddie Roach did an interview this week with the Australian newspaper where he said, "To be honest with you guys, Jeff Horn won the fight fair and square. Clearly won."
Couldn't have said
it. He said it. It's in a newspaper article.
Oh wow! It's ridiculous to say something like that. Everybody knows that Pacquiao won that fight.
Yeah, I know. And then I went to visit Charlo in Houston this week,
yes.
and he's in camp with Derek James, obviously, and with Juan Guzman. And Juan goes, "Hey, I remember you from Oxnard, and Robert's gym used to be in the house when he was with you. Tell me about that, because Juan Guzman's a really nice guy."
Yeah, you know, Juan Guzman, you know, was one of those fighters in my gym that, you know, he would get everybody in line, from kids to pros, and he would give them $20 for every punch they landed.
Did anyone land on him?
He never gave any dollars away. He never gave any $20 out. Nobody would land.
Wow. Super talented. He's still in shape.
That guy was so talented, man. It was, you know, the guys were swinging hard to try to beat on the kids. You know, they would get in line. You know, we could have 20 kids in line and nobody would land. Nobody ever landed. You know, when he was focused like that and playing around with the kids, yeah. Nobody would ever land. He was talented. He's probably been the most talented fighter of the Dominican Republic ever.
And Charlo's so excited, so happy. He's ready to fight Castaño tonight.
So what's his name? So he's an assistant coach there?
I think so. Yeah, because Derek James is like the head coach, and he works with Charlo as well.
Because I know he was in New York and living in New York.
Correct. So he was in New York, and he left New York to be with Charlo for this camp in Houston.
Oh, that's so good. Good for him.
Yeah.
That's good for him. I knew he was in New York, and I remember when Mikey came back first time after he left Top Rank for 2.5 years.
Yes.
Well, John Guzman was a trainer of the guy that Mikey fought.
Ilio Rojas, where the guy was talking much smack. Yeah.
Well, Guzman was the...
The trainer?
The trainer in that fight. So now he's in Texas with Charlo. That's good for him, man. I'm happy for him.
Yeah.
Great person, but yeah, very, very talented. One of the most talented fighters, you know, in his era. You know, he was, you know, I think he was avoided by many. I don't think Pacquiao ever wanted to fight him.
I don't think anybody wanted to fight him.
Yeah, he was very difficult. Yeah, he was very talented.
And like I said, really, and his English, because he's with Jermell a lot, his English improved way above and beyond. Because in New York, all he had to do was speak Spanish. He was good.
Yeah. That's
so now I mean, he's cool. He's a cool dude. And then, what do you think, Charlo Castaño? I mean, I watch Charlo train. He's ready to fight right now.
Yeah, well, I'm sure he's training hard because, you know, the first fight was very controversial. It was very close, and a lot of people thought Castaño won. So he's training hard, and I'm sure he'll be better than ever to try to prove everybody wrong. You know, me personally, I would love to see Castaño win. You know, I know Sebastián Contursi, and that's the only reason, man, because of the relationship I have with Sebastián Contursi, being that he managed Maidana, and we did great things with Maidana and Cuellar.
Yeah.
So he's a friend of mine. So you know, I'm definitely cheering and hoping, you know, everything goes well for them. But Charlo was very talented, man. You know, and Charlo could come back and then surprise the world. And a lot of people think that Castaño could beat him, but hey, it could be that, you know, it could be, you know, where Charlo comes out and puts a real statement on the division.
Not only that, but I learned this week that Charlo started boxing at a very young age, that he's been following the sport. He fought Errol Spence in amateurs, by the way. I didn't even know that.
Was that right?
But yeah, but he like watches boxing and he studies the sport.
So he's trained.
I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.